Google is ending their Google Cloud Print service. So that means that you can't use that anymore to print from your Chromebook. Now, that's pretty bad, right? When you first look at it, you go, oh no, how am I going to be able to print? Am I going to have to use some type of service, pay for an app or something else? And the answer is no, you don't. This morning, I went to print for my Chromebook and Google Cloud Print service basically is no more. And I thought, okay, what am I going to do? Well, let's see what their solution is. And I went to the app store, looked through different apps, and they want money, you know, to have this service that used to be free. And so I go, no, there must be a way to do this for free. So in this video, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to print from your Chromebook to your printer without having to download an app, without having to pay for a service. And it's going to be done all for those who are in their home, meaning this is not for the enterprise user. This is for the home user who has a Chromebook, has a printer, and wants to use it. Hey, before we get into those steps, this is Selma Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. And if you are new to the channel, I hope that you hit subscribe and click on the thumbs up and share the video so that others can see the steps too on how to print from their Chromebook to their printer. Now, in the past, what we need to do is we would have a Google Cloud Print, and that was a free service that existed. And if you had a Google account, like a Gmail account, you could add a printer to that account so that you'd be able to print to your printer regardless of your location and regardless of your device. All you had to do is log into your Gmail. From there, you go Control P and you'd see your printer, you'd print to it, and you could be in Hawaii and print to your printer that was in your office over in California. Not a problem. No limitations there. So it was a great service. But like I said, Google has discontinued that, and it won't be seen any longer after December 31st, 2020. So this is really important for you guys to know these steps on how to set up your printers. Now, there are many other solutions out there, printer solutions, apps, stuff like that, and even services that you can go with and pay them to do this. But like I said, this is going to be absolutely free. And all you need to do is go to your printer. And what I did was I own a Brother's printer. And I went and I printed out the printer settings. Now, I did that so I'd see all of the printer settings, so I know exactly what I'm up against here. And there's two different numbers or two different settings that are really important to you in doing these steps. Number one is the IPP enabled. Now, I went on Walmart.com, I went to Amazon.com, went to different places, and all the printers that I found there were network printers, and therefore they had the IPP enabled by default. But let's just say that, you know, you never know out there, you go to your printer and the IPP is disabled for some reason. All you need to do is go to your printer, go into the settings, and once you're into the settings, look for the setting called IPP and make sure that's enabled. Now, like I said, 100% of the printers I looked at this morning, they were all enabled. No corrections needed. But just in case, now you know what to do. Now, once you've made sure that your IPP is enabled, the next thing that you want to do is you want to find that IP address. Now, it's going to be some number that's not 0.0.0.0. The very first number on my sheets here, it says IP address and it's all zeros. Well, that's not the one that we're looking for. It's going to be an actual number, kind of like the one that I'm showing here. And once you find a number similar to this one, you say, aha, that's the IP address that I need. And how do you find that? Well, you can go again into your printer settings, go down the settings until you find what's called IP settings. And from IP settings, the very first words there are IP address. And it says 192.168.1.131. And basically, that's the number that you need. Now, your IP address will be different than mine, okay? Any printers will be different, but it will be some number similar to that. And that's given by your router, by your internet router. Now, once you have that information there, make sure that's written down or printed out in some way so that you can get to it. Because now we're going to go into the Chromebook settings, and I'm going to show you where to put that number in to set up your printer so that your Chromebook will print straight to your printer without having to use any apps, and it's all done free. Hey, here I am in the Chromebook. Now what you're going to do is you're going to click over there on the time. Once you click on the time, you see the notifications come up there, and you need to click on the icon that looks like a gear icon there towards the top. I'm clicking on that now, and that is, it says settings. So go ahead and click on settings, and it opens up into the settings. Now once you have the settings up, notice at the top is a search box. Now you could spend, you know, hours and hours looking through all of your hundreds of wonderful Chromebook settings, but what we're going to forego all that and simply click in at the top where it says the search box and type in the word printer. Now once you typed in printer, hit that enter key once and it finds the settings that we need. Now notice right there towards the middle of the screen, it's an important one. It says add printer. So go ahead and click on add printer. And we get into this specialty box here. Now at the very first setting, it's name. You may say, well, why do I need to name my printer? Well, it could be very important, especially if you add new printers or you buy new printers for your home in the future. So you want to give it the name that you want. In my case, I have three different printers and they're in my house there. So they're all networked and they're all from Brother. So I'm going to call this one Brother and Office. So I'm going to give that name there. And that part is important that we'll come back to in a little bit later here. Once you give it a name, go ahead now and give it the IP address. And notice in the settings it just says address. Well, that's the IPP address or the IP address that you found earlier in by looking at your printer there. Now, just to let you know, it does not have any spaces in there. So it's just number dot number dot number dot number there. There's no spaces or letters or anything like that. It's just straight numbers and the periods. Once you've done that, click at the bottom there. Notice it says add. So go ahead and click on add. So now you've added a printer to your Chromebook. So now what we're going to do is we're going to test this out and make sure that your Chromebook actually prints to your printer. You want to test out right away, make sure you've done the right things. So open to any page, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my Google Drive and I'm going to open up a Google document. There we go. And now once I'm at my Google document, I'm going to make sure that it prints. So I'm going to go Control P. That's a shortcut that you use to print from your Chromebook, Control P. And once you do that, you get the printer dialog box that comes up. Now over on the side, notice that it says destination. Your destination has to be changed to the new printer that you just added. So click on there. And notice it says see more. Click on see more. And now from that list, you're going to select that new printer that you just added. And that's why I say it's so important to give it a name that you know which one it is, because it's possible that you might have other printers in there with very similar names. And click it. Once you've clicked it, you'll get back to this printer dialog box and then click on the blue button that says print. And it should print out that page for you. Hey, so now you know how to add a printer straight to your Chromebook without having to use any drivers, without having to use any apps, without having to pay for any service. And like I said, it's all done 100% free. All you needed was a printer that had made sure that the IPP address was enabled. Find that IP address by going into the printer's settings, writing it down, going into your Chromebook settings, going into printer, giving it that information, clicking on add, and there you go. And hey, if you like these types of videos, make sure you do have that thumbs up clicked once there and share the video, because now this is the only way that you could print now that Google Cloud Print has gone away. Thank you again for watching the video. And if you have a question on there, please make sure that you do leave it down in the comments, and I'll try to get to those comments or that question as soon as I can. Thank you again, and bye-bye.